a fucking idiot.
Well, I think it looks pretty cool. I don't exactly appreciate it.
You look like a clown!
Excuse me? Excuse me. Alright, I don't exactly appreciate your constant naysaying. This wig is now more part of my life than your sister's leg is to hers.
My sister's prosthetic leg allows her to walk.
Well, my prosthetic hair gives me self-confidence, and that's something you can't put a price on.
You humiliate me.
Roger thinks it's cool.
Roger's a douchebag.
Oh, hey guys! Great day out, huh? Great day.
Why are you wearing that?
Looking great, Raj! Thanks!
Roger's a friend, and I really wish you wouldn't talk about him like that.
I don't understand where you all got the idea that dressing like you're going to a drag show is the equivalent of wearing a hat.
You all? Come on, Paige.
You, Roger, Mick.
Sup?
Even your parents.
Sup?
I'm sick of it. I don't want to be the girlfriend of the guy with the wig anymore.
Then why are you riding in a car with me right now?
Because I needed to get my homework.
Because you needed me?
Scarr!
Ah! I'll be right here.
Ooh. On the brakes! Brakes on a bus, brakes on a car. Brakes to make you a superstar. And brakes to lose, but these here brakes rock your shoes, and these...
What?
Where's my homework?
Inside somewhere. I'll grab it in a minute.
Where? I'll grab it.
Can't we just enjoy the day for a second?
Jesus Christ, I just need my homework.
Whoa! Relax, Pahina. Why so steamy?
My idiot boyfriend won't stop wearing this wig, okay?
What? Like, to be funny?
No, to wear. All the time. The worst part is, his friends and family started wearing him now too. It's like they think he's...
Wait a minute! When did this start?
I don't know, a couple weeks ago?
Was it March 30th?
Somewhere around there, why?
Holy shitballs! I was just reading about this.
What was March 30th?
March 30th was a full moon. Let me ask you something. Would you call his wig... magnificently silver?
I suppose.
Paige, what I'm about to tell you.
Yes?
Your boyfriend's hair is possessed by a demon spirit.
Joey, you're retarded.
I am not retarded. It's all here, look for yourself. According to the book, every decade or so, there's a certain uprising.
An uprising of demon wigs.
Precisely. It all starts with one wig. Someone tries it on to be funny, whatever, but it becomes attached. Soon, the wig takes over the host head's hair, and it becomes inseparable.
The wig has great powers.
Great powers to influence those around it. The original wig births new wigs, and soon, those close to the original host begin to be possessed by the demon spirit as well.
All with the intention of global demon wig takeover. How come I've never heard about this before? This has gotta be fake, right?
Oh, but you have heard of this before. The reason it's never been in the news is because there's always been a woman, a girlfriend, a wife, to stop it from growing.
How do they stop it?
They kill the host, and then they cut off the head, and then they bury it. The thing is, the responsibility has always fallen onto one family.
No.
The Steele family. Your family, Paige. Read on.
Each woman has held the power to stop the uprising, and each has succeeded. Susan Steele in the 60s. Veronica Steele in the 80s. Laura Steele in the 90s.
And Paige Steele in 2010. You have to take this responsibility.
I can't kill my boyfriend.
It's not whether you can or can't. It's that you must. I don't want our nation run by evil wigs. I don't even want to wear a wig.
This isn't real. Grab my homework, I gotta go.
It's real, Paige. And you, and only you, have the power to stop this. Deep down inside, you've always known you'd have to do this. Here, let me go get my book that teaches you how to kill a guy.
Just get my homework!
I'm sorry, I totally spaced. What was I going in there for again?
Where's the homework?
What? Oh, he didn't have it.
What a loser.
Let's get out of here.
This is Kajagoogoo. I love this song. If I start the car, it's gonna get interrupted.
Are you kidding? Shh. Let's go.
Shh. The song.
I should change it.